I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl? It's a boy.
A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. My beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're
James?
Just a... Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions.
James.
Get the baby out of here. Move, move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on.
Okay?
You one. We need a doctor, not a dead man.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations
no.
And there will
Don't
be
look
trouble.
Look straight into the light.
James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations.
Hey, your future's
just
bright.
Boys in this place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son.
Daddy.
Come on. Walk to Daddy. You can do it. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Thank you.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amata wants to play.
These experiments
don't
are
be a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He was growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As Overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10. Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now?
Get lost,
hey, Wooly,
butt breath.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things, believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Birthday.
Come on,
yeah,
mingle.
Paul, why don't you introduce us to your new best friend?
Happy birthday, Sonny.
Who do you mean, dork face here? Happy birthday, dork face.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amata put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the Overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Are you having a nice time? Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks! What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am, rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Attention, everyone. It's time to cut the cake.
Andy!
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? and we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Wait! Nice party, Blanket. I'll get lost before I have to make you cry.
How's it going, pal? Having a good time?
No.
It wasn't easy keeping this
allow
a secret.
To wish you a
now go on.
Birthday.
I'm sure everyone else would like a chance to talk to the birthday boy.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake! Give me that sweet roll you got from Old Lady Palmer. Share it. What are you, five? Give me that sweet roll, I'm gonna pound you. Oh, yeah? We'll see about that. Say, Uncle.
I told you not to act all official. I know you were joking,
Butch,
but
what do you think you're doing?
Sure,
leave him alone.
Did. What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk. Right. That's exactly what I was thinking.
You all right, son?
Wally. You always
he
have
didn't
good
hurt
ideas.
You, did. I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about? That's fine, son. I'm glad to see you're not letting Butch bully you. He's going to be a handful in a few years if his mother doesn't take him in hand. Well, no harm done, then. Why don't you get back to enjoying your party?
Yeah.
Enjoying yourself?
The Mackers.
You're having a nice
super
time.
Super cool, right?
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again? I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it. Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
Jeez, Wally.
Thanks
who's
for coming,
the game?
Stanley.
You or me?
I know
no
you were
way.
Busy with the
allow
water.
Allow me to wish you a happy birthday.
Everything's fine, I hope.
Jonas?
Oh, sure, nothing to worry about.
Hey, Doc.
Me and Andy got her all,
we're all set down here.
Last night. Good as new.
Thanks.
I wasn't worried.
I'll send him right down.
Well on his way to becoming a...
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Happy birthday!
I'm glad you can make it.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem, just for you. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
How are you?
Like everybody's having a good time in there.
Please place all trash into the appropriate incineration receptacle on your scheduled burning day.
Enjoy the party, sir?
Bah! I only showed up because Amata's friends with the brat. Give them a few more minutes, and then I want that place cleaned up and everybody back to work.
Sure thing, sir. Sounds like everybody's having a good time in there.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? We sure can't, unless we want the Overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on. Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Happy birthday, buddy. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot. You'll be fine. Good work. That's one less rad roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is her problem
right?
Anyway? So, I'm the Overseer's daughter,
Gloria.
So what?
That
like, I get any
word.
Kind of special
Tell
treatment.
Me.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the Vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the Vault, we die in the Vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all Vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? That's not the way it works, and it won't do to go around asking questions like that, especially not around the Overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know. But it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the Overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have. Because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either. That's what the Overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here. Your mother, she was beautiful, but beyond the beauty you've seen. There's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate about life, about love. But most of all, she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, son, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner. Take care, son. I got out of here, and good luck.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh? Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see us.
Morning, Jonas.
It's the big... Morning, Doc. How's things?
Have you had a chance to look over these results?
I was just going over them. Something you're worried about?
I'd just like to keep an eye on it.
No problem. I'll have my report ready this afternoon.
Sounds good. Let me know if there are any changes.
I'm a little worried. I hope Jonas can take a look at me soon.
Hi, Stanley. Sorry to keep you waiting. What seems to be the trouble today?
I've got this headache that just won't go away. Even with the pills you gave
me
last week.
What is it now, sir?
It's the lights, I think. They hurt my eyes.
That's God, Butch, why don't you just leave me alone?
Well, she's nothing, Butch.
Go show it to her, Butch.
Daddy on us?
I think I'd like that.
What's the matter?
Will it take
Daddy's
long?
Girl gonna cry?
Oh, shouldn't be too long.
Tell her, Butch.
Get away from me!
I'll be with you as soon as
I can. You think you're special because your daddy is the overseer? She's nothing, Butch.
Back off, Butch.
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amara.
Stupid tunnel snakes! Immature assholes, if you ask me! Why won't they leave me alone? It's not my fault my father's the overseer. I don't care about their stupid gang. Can you talk to them? Maybe Butch will listen to you. Please? A bunch of idiots, if you ask me. They think they're so tough with their gang. All they ever do is hang around and cause trouble. They've got it in for me because my father is the overseer. Like, that's my fault. Thanks. You've always been a good friend. Try talking to Butch. They'll all do whatever he says.
Let's go into the storeroom, Amara. Don't mess with the tunnel snakes. What? You mouthing off, Spaz? Everyone knows the tunnel snakes. We rule this vault, and we don't take shit from nobody. Not you, not her, and not her daddy, the overseer. Stay out of this. It's tunnel snake business. Me and Butch were just having some fun with this chick. I don't follow anyone. Wally Mack is his own man, and the tunnel snakes is where I belong. Why? You think Butch is in charge? Is that what people are saying? Because it's a load of shit if that's what they're saying. What? What kind of shit is that? No one talks that way about Wally Mack. He's not the boss of me. Nobody's the boss of me. I'm out of here. We're done here. Don't mess with the tunnel. Why don't you mind your own business? Last I checked, you weren't a tunnel snake. Run along, kid, before Butch and I decide you're a problem. Get out of here, kid.
Tunnel snakes rule. That's us, and we rule. No one messes with the tunnel snakes, or they have to answer to Butch and Wally. You don't want to be on their bad sides. Trust me. None of your business, because Butch said so. And what Butch says goes. Tunnel snakes rule! Because he's my pal. My brother. All us tunnel snakes are brothers. Birth to earth. Womb to tomb. Mostly because tunnel snakes rule! Can't think of anything. Butch says this little bitch is blabbing to her daddy about us tunnel snakes. We can't have that. Because we're the tunnel snakes, and we rule. Much later, tunnel snakes rule.
Done. This don't know who put you in charge. This I say we're done. America. Let's go, Paul.
Are you sure? Butch? Okay. Whatever you say, Wally.
This isn't over.
Tunnel snakes rule. Fine, let's go. I was done here anyway. This ain't over, Daddy's girl. I'm not finished with you either, twerp.
Thank God that's over.
This isn't over, punk.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. Take your seats so we can get started.
I hope you weren't just talking to me.
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response? Question 2. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question 3. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do?
The overseer's authority is absolute.
Question 4. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question 5. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do? Question 6. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question 7. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Hey there. Yes?
Looks like the diner's going to get a new fry cook. I'll just say this once. Hold the mustard, extra pickles. Listen, I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously. And look where I ended up. Just between you and me, the whole test is a joke. If you don't like the results, I can make your goat come out any way you want. Just let me know. Surely you have someplace better to be than hanging around my classroom.
Leave me alone, you little spaz.
Stop bothering me. I've just got to figure out this last one.
Don't worry about Miss Almodovar. Let's see.
Oh, look, it's Doc's kid. Great. What do you want, nerd boy? This isn't over, punk.
I'll see you tomorrow, bright
nerd. Anything is possible, even an egg.
That is
Dr. Rain
here to save you now. Is he
helping me get back to work? Selfish and insubordinate.
Wake up!
You
come on, wake up!
These things. I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you! He's left the vault! I don't know how, but he's gone, and my father, he's kind of gone crazy. It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men! They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now! Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. Not anymore, apparently. But are you honestly telling me you had no idea your dad was leaving? He really didn't tell you? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck! You need to get moving, and be careful. The security men are everywhere. My father ordered the vault into lockdown. Everyone's supposed to stay in their quarters and emergency lighting only. But you need to be careful. The Radroaches have swarmed out into the darkness. I had a few close calls on my way to see you. It was lucky for you in a way. Security's been distracted dealing with the roaches, but that won't last forever. You've got to get moving. Well, that's what they've always told us, but apparently it's not. From what I overheard, he hacked into the computer that controls the door. That's why my father locked down the door leading to the exit. I don't think they meant to, as if that makes any difference. I think he must have distracted the guards while your dad got into the vault door controls. When they realized that Jonas had helped your dad escape, they just lost it. I'm sorry, but I really don't want to think about it again. Good luck. I'll try to meet up with you after you get the vault door open. I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't... Wait for me.
There he is. Hold it right there.
Crime anymore, roaches.
Had enough. Stop in the name of the overseer. You know, I liked you, Dad. I guess he had us all fooled. No!
gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches!
Do not interfere with vault security
personnel. No, I can't go back in there. It's dark, and there's rat roaches. Oh my God! Thank you! I didn't know what to do! You're the best! You're the best friend I've ever had, man. Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my Tunnel Snake's jacket. Go ahead, take it.
Those things. Where did those things come from? Oh, I need another drink.
You're the best, man. The best. Everything's gonna be okay now, thanks to you.
You're lucky it was me who found you. The others won't be so forgiving. I don't know what you're up to, and I don't want to know. Just clear out of here, and I'll pretend I never saw you. It's a real shame it's come to this. I can't believe what they did to Jonas. Officer Mack was just out of control. But you're a good kid. You didn't do anything to deserve this. Go find your dad if you can.
No. I'm afraid you've missed him. I believe he's gone topside.
Come on, kid, get out of here before you get us both killed.
We'll be back any moment.
You're the one. Me and Andy were in a tight spot there. No mistake. Good thing he loves toasting roaches so much. Just hold still. Your left stabilizer's been knocked loose.
I am holding.
still. It's your old pulsing hands that are shaking.
If you keep turning like that, I'm gonna crack your casing.
Don't blame me for your incompetence. My heart remembered George used to have the...
Almost got it.
I think you just made it worse. Should I do this myself?
We'll just go back to our quarters.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me,
Tommy!
Watch out!
He had to go and leave, didn't he? He had to mess things up for everybody. George!
Hold it right there! I'm hit! The punishment of truth is death.
Oh my God!
You gotta leave the kids over here.
God.
He's trying to leave the ball. Don't leave him, will you?
Officer Mac may enjoy this, but I don't. Just tell us where to find your friend so we can talk to him.
He's my friend.
I knew you'd turn up sooner or later. Ow! What's the matter, huh? Can't stand the sight of your own blood?
I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young man. You're already in enough trouble as it is. Don't make it worse for yourself. I place the good of the vault above everything, even my own paternal feelings. We must not allow sentiment to cloud our judgment. But I admire your protective instincts. Very well. I give you my word that Amata will not suffer further because of your actions. Now then, if you really care about Amata, you will see how dangerous your father's actions were. Hand over your weapons, and put an end to this dangerous situation. There is no need to join your father as a traitor to the vault. Oh, is that all? Is there anything else I can get you while you're here? You'll get nothing from me. I'll die before I see the safety of the vault compromised again. Save your sanctimony. The world is a dangerous place, and I make no apologies for doing whatever it takes to keep the vault safe.
Guards, help me!
I have nothing else to...
Guards, help! Guards, help! He's here. Don't let him get away.